As family and friends of 20-year-old Mackenzie Mann continued reading impact statements today, her grandfather spoke about learning the unimaginable news. I felt as if a piece of my soul was ripped out and the hole was filled with grief. It was June 3rd, 2020, just before 10 p.m., that Bulend Typhoon Dikici, who was 19 at the time, T-boned another car at Airport Anibo Roads at a speed over 140 kilometers an hour, which is double the posted limit.
Every single time we have to come in, we have to see him, it's painful and it's awful.
Mackenzie, who had her seatbelt on, was in the rear passenger side seat when she was killed. Three others were injured. Childhood friends like Cassandra Cozen have been holding rallies calling for justice.
I will not stop saying her name. I will shout it from rooftops if I have to. And I know that she will be doing the exact same thing for me.
Dikici pleaded guilty to criminal negligence causing death. He had been drinking before getting behind the wheel, which is not allowed as a G2 driver, but police determined he was not legally impaired. Today, he sat in court with his head down as Mackenzie's grandfather, William Mann, turned to him and said, "I wish for your life to be short-lived, filled with pain and sorrow. When you die, I hope you scream in fear, as I'm sure my Mackenzie did. I have no forgiveness to give you. That part of me died with Mackenzie." Dikici prepared a statement today, but he sat as his lawyer read it to the court. He says that he expresses his condolences to friends and family and accepts responsibility. Everyone should know speeding isn't okay and your life can change in a second.
If he was truly remorseful, you'd have the dignity to stand up yourself and read your own impact statement or how you were impacted by what you caused.
In closing arguments, Dikici's attorney Jamie Stevenson told the court that in my years as a defense counsel, I've never seen so much hate for an unintentional act. She described witnessing threats toward her client within the courthouse, to which the judge called distressing. The defense suggested Dikici be sentenced to 2 to 3 years in jail, a time frame that friends say isn't long enough.
Mackenzie lost her entire life. We are suffering, we've now been suffering for 17 months and that's not gonna end anytime soon. And you got 2 to 3 years because of a choice you made and you caused, that's ridiculous.
The Crown is asking Dikici be sentenced to 6 to 8 years behind bars with a 10-year driving prohibition. Justice Tory Colvin is expected to deliver his decision on December 13th. Nicole Martin, CHCH News.